Mr. and Mrs. Johnson, I need you to brace yourselves. Right now, your daughter's condition is slowly improving, but once she is to learn of what's happened to her husband and her child, I'm afraid it might actually, I don't know, take a turn for the worse.
So you're saying we should hold off telling what happened?
Precisely. Right now, her recovery is the most important thing right now. What happens when she wakes up and she asks where her child and husband are? What do we tell her then?
Once again, I am so sorry. I want to give you guys some time alone with your grandson. Call me when you need me.
We have a grandson. Beautiful, beautiful grandson.
Brian's dead? I can't believe this. This started out as the most wonderful day and is now turned into the worst nightmare of my life.
Jazz, I don't know what to say. I'm so sorry about... I just can't believe that James and the baby are both dead. And what about Mika? Does she know?
No, not yet. She's still unconscious. They said she's going to make a full recovery, but she hasn't woken up yet. I can't bear the thought of when she finds out about her husband's baby. Monica, I have to see Brittany. What room is she at? I have to see her.
As far as I know, she's in room 411. But Jazz, don't worry about Brittany. I'll keep watch on Brittany. Right now, you need to focus on Mika and your family.
Mama and Daddy are with Mika, and she's still unconscious. And right now, there's nothing much I can do. But I need to see Brittany. I need to see her. Just for peace of mind. I'm going to see her. Excuse me. Can you tell me where I can find room 411? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you were busy. You know what? Don't worry about it. I'll find it on my own.
Oh, no, that's okay. Just go down the hallway. Make a left, and you'll find room 411, two doors to your right. But if you excuse me, I have to get this body prepared for the family. I need to call the Wilcox family real quick.
You mean this is Brian Wilcox's body? Oh my God, I can't believe he's really dead.
Did you know him, miss?
He was one of my closest friends. And most recently, he was my boyfriend. And I just now realized something. The last thing he said to me was that he still loves me. And he will always love me. And I told him to get out of my life. That's the last thing he ever heard from me.
Oh, I am so sorry, miss. Look, I'm sure that he knows that you love him. Excuse me. I need to go call the family.
Brian, I'm so sorry this happened to you. And I'm so sorry what I said to you. No matter how I felt, I still love you. I never stop loving you. No matter how hard I try to push you away. And I may have been mad, but I know in your heart you still love me. You have been my first love. My first true love. And I will always love you. May you sleep with the angels, beautiful one. My prince. Goodbye, Brian.
that you? What happened? Where am I at? You're in the hospital, sweetie. Okay? You're fine, okay? Take it easy, okay? Don't overexert yourself. Hold on, I'll get the doctor, all right?
In the hospital? Why am I in the hospital? Mama! Where's James? Where's James, Mama? Why am I in the
baby!
Is the baby okay?
Look, I'm gonna get the doctor, okay? And he'll explain anything to you, all right? Just relax, okay?
I don't wanna relax! Why aren't you telling me anything? Where is James and the baby, Mama? Where are they at?
Baby, please, calm down, all right? Let me call the doctor, let me get the doctor, and he'll explain anything to you, okay? You just need to calm down, all right? Right, come on, Mika. You just woke up, all right? Just, please, just trust me on this, all right?
Fine! If you're not gonna tell me, then I'll find out my damn self! Mika, wait!
I drove out to the middle of nowhere, the deepest dark of night. Pulled out my suitcase and started to fill it with things that were not mine. I then drove across this great nation, hoping to find the bright lights. But all I found was the desert and ghost towns. They'll probably haunt me for life. I've been a lot of places. I've been so many places, and there's no place.